Have a nice and safe day to all my viewers. I welcome you all again for another new topic in this video tutorial, that is about biomolecules. Okay. In this video, we'll discuss up to the properties, structure and properties of amino acids. In the next video, we'll discuss the rest part. Okay. So let's discuss. What are biomolecules? Okay. If we define the biomolecule, it is said that all organic compounds or organic carbon compounds, not all organic compounds, all organic carbon containing compounds, carbon containing compounds are called as biomolecules. Clear? So the biomolecules are present inside the living tissues. These biomolecules are present inside living tissues. Okay? So we cannot tell all the carbon containing compounds are biomolecule, because suppose we'll take the example of carbon dioxide. It is not a biomolecule, because the biomolecules are always organic compounds having carbon. Clear? So these biomolecules are again classified and categorized into macromolecule and micromolecule. So let's discuss what are these. How can we define macro and micromolecule? Suppose there is an experiment. This is one of the living tissue. And we homogenate this tissue in trichloroacetic acid media. After grinding it within a media containing trichloroacetic acid. This trichloroacetic acid. This is the living tissue with the help of motor vessel or with help of other tissue homogenizer. We have grinded this tissue into small parts. Okay. What happened after that? Some of the contents of the tissue get dissolved within it, while some other part remain intact. Okay. After grinding, it is we are following to filter it. When it is filtered, what happened? Some of the, suppose this is the filter, this is the filter. After filtering it, some compounds, they pass through the filter, some compounds pass through the filter and collected here, while some other remain within it. Okay, this is filtrate and this is filtrant. Okay, so these molecules which are non-soluble called as biomacromolecule. Then the non-soluble substance which are obtained from it are biomacromolecule. Macromolecule. Okay. And the substances which are soluble inside it, the soluble compounds are biomicromolecule. Biomicromolecule. Okay. There is a specific size of macro and micromolecule. What are? Suppose the molecular weight is between more than 800 Dalton in biomacromolecule. But here in biomicromolecule, the molecular weight is between 18 to 800 Dalton. Okay. So this is the difference between biomacromolecule and biomicromolecule. Okay. What are the example? What are macromolecule? What are micromolecule then? If we consider the macromolecule, it may be polysaccharide, it may be RNA, it may be DNA, it may be protein. All sorts of compounds are biomacromolecules. What are biomicromolecules? The micromolecules include soluble compounds. Okay, this may be amino acids. This may be glucose. Okay, then these are micromolecules. The micromolecule congregate producing macromolecule. Okay, so this is the basic difference between biomacro and micromolecule. In all cases, these are carbon containing organic compounds. Rather, the molecular size and molecular weight is variable. Okay, so let's discuss amino acid first. Let's discuss amino acid. Amino acids. What are amino acids? The amino acids are compounds containing carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, sulfur, so many complexes are present in its side chain. These are otherwise called as substituted methane. Okay. Substituted methane. Suppose this is methane. Okay, CH4. Substituted methane means the central carbon atom is present here. It is substituted by amine group, carboxyl group, hydrogen, and R. This R is side chain. The side chain is variable in different amino acids and all three are constant. Clear? So, these three groups are constant, R is variable. Okay? So, these are substituted methane. Okay? If we consider the structure out of the 20 essential amino acids, remember, three structures. The simplest amino acid. What is that? GAS. Okay. How? Glycine. This G for glycine, alanine, then serine. Okay. Okay. So, glycine. It is the simplest amino acid and it is optically inactive. Okay. Why? This is amine group, hydrogen, carboxyl group. This is in place of R, here hydrogen is present. So it is simplest. Okay. Here this is amine group, hydrogen carboxyl group, and this in this place CH3. Okay, the complexity rises here, and here hydrogen, amine group, carboxyl group, here alcohol CH2H. Okay, so this is serine. Okay. The carbon are chiral carbon. Why these are chiral? Asymmetric carbon atom, because this is symmetric carbon. All these valency are occupied by same compound. But here these are asymmetric carbon. These asymmetric carbon shows mutarotation. These are optically active except glycine. All amino acids are optically active except glycine. Clear? So, These are the basic structure of amino acid. We can also categorize L amino acid, D amino acid on the basis of the position of amine group. Okay, dextrorotatory and laborotatory amino acids. The amino acids carries one acid and one basic group. So these are neutral. These are neutral in nature. Okay, then come to some properties of amino acids. 20 essential amino acids are there, which generally occur in protein, except 20 other 3 amino acids are also there. Okay. Suppose this is the amino acid, hydrogen, amino group, carboxyl group, and this is R. Whatever may be the side chain. When these amino acids are placed in a media, neutral media, what happens? The hydrogen from this carboxyl group donated to amine group, and here this became NH3+, this became COO-. Okay, so it carries both positive and negative charges in it. Okay, due to both charges, these are called as Zwitter ions amino acids. Okay, this is the prime property of all amino acids. Then the second, when these amino acids are placed in another media, suppose this is the hydrogen, amine group, carboxyl group, R, placed in acidic medium. Okay, acidic medium. Acidic means kya hoga? It carries hydrogen. The concentration of hydrogen is more within the media. Okay, concentration of hydrogen is more within the media. Okay, what happens in the acidic media? The acid part of amino acid is not active, rather the base is activated. Which part is base? Acid group does not behave acidic, and here in such cases the hydrogen donated to NH2 and it became NH3+. Okay, so it became hydrogen, here it became NH3+. Clear? So in acidic media, the amino acid behave as a base, act as a base rather than acidic. Okay, so it became opposite property. Similarly, when the medium is alkaline, basic, what happens? Suppose this is the amino acid, R group, CO group, this is alkaline media, means OH concentration is more, what happened? The base is not active here. How? Carboxyl group donate is producing water. It became CO-. The base remain intact. Okay. So this is called as the in basic medium, it act as acid. Okay, so in basic medium it act as acid, acidic medium it act as base. This property of amino acid is called as amphoteric property. Let's discuss about different categories of amino acids. The amino acids are categorized into different types on the basis of their side chain, because all others are constant. Side chain or R group. When R group carries hydrocarbon, CH, CH2, CH3, these are called as simple amino acids. Simple. When R group carries OH group, these are hydroxy amino acid. When R carries COH group, another, these are acidic amino acids. When R carries another amine group, these are basic amino acid. When R carries a benzene ring, these are aromatic amino acids. Okay. When R carries heterocycle, one hexagon, another pentagon, these are heterocyclic amino acids. Okay. So there are different type of amino acids which are categorized on the basis of side chain. Okay. So in these cases, we have in this video we have already discussed about different amino acid and properties. The amino acid react to produce protein. How? The amino acids linked by producing peptide linkage. So the proteins are polypeptides. We'll discuss about polypeptide in the coming video. Thank you all.